Didn't I read last night on a tape that the families that started the Federal Reserve included Hoffman? Goldman Sachs, Rockefellers, Lehman's, and Kuhn Loebs, the Rothschilds of Paris and London, the Warburgs of Hamburg, the Lazards of Paris, and the Israel's Moses Seifs of Rome. Maybe the Hoffmans are on another list. The Hoffmans are really, really, really rich. I know that from wherever it was posted. The Hoffmans, I thought the Hoffmans were on the list of the families that started the Federal Reserve. It's eight families. The Four Horsemen of Banking. Shit. This may be religious. Thank you. The Hoffmans must be on another list. So, I apologize because I think it was inaccurate. So, it isn't religious, I guess. This is 10 banks. Okay, I just want to make sure it's not way wacky religious. The Four Horsemen of Banking. Wow, shit. Apparently, according to this text, which seems half credible at least, it's ten families own the 12 reserve banks. probably better. Right. Sometimes. love to.
Please. Thank you for calling Advocate Aurora Health. This call may be monitored or recorded for quality assurance purposes. Aurora Behavioral Health, this is Amber. How may I help you?
Hi, Amber. I would like to schedule some appointments with Julie.
Okay. And your name?
Laura Landsberg.
How do you spell the last name?
LANDSBERG.
And you said, what was the first name?
Laura, L-A-U-R.
Laura, okay. And your birthday?
February 24th, 1959. Before she left. Before maternity.
Okay.
I spoke with Gregory Henderson a few times.
Okay. Got it. Okay. So, let's see here. And then you just do the video with her, obviously?
That's a little easier. Is she doing in office now?
She is, on Mondays.
No, I'd rather schedule a video because... I'm having a little difficulty physically, okay.
No problem. Okay, so, let's see. Is there a day or a time that works better for you?
Afternoon always works better. Like after 2 p.m.
Okay. And any day then?
My days are pretty open, so no.
Okay. All right. So I could put you in with her already on June 23rd, which is a Wednesday at 4 o'clock.
That would be perfect.
Okay.
And then should I go ahead and schedule another one? Is she filling up really fast? Is she filling up really fast? Should I go ahead and schedule another one?
Well...
She'll do it. Okay.
Her schedule is kind of... I mean, if you're a follow-up, like, I would say we can get you in probably fairly easily.
Right.
It just all depends on the day. I have to look at it when she would, you know, hit when she has. But...
Okay.
I actually might have to change you on that day because I realize she's got a group session at 4:30, so that won't
okay.
work.
Right.
So let me look at another day.
Okay.
That if you're looking for an afternoon appointment.
If morning's easier, that's also fine. If morning is she...
Well, or we could do that day, that same day, if you would do... Do you want to do a 1 o'clock?
Well, of course.
Would that work okay?
That would be just fine.
Okay, so let's do that. We'll stick it with June 23rd at 1 o'clock.
All right.
And then were you seeing her every couple of weeks? Or a little farther out than that?
Maybe every 3 weeks, I think. Or
every 3 weeks? Okay.
Or a week and then a follow-up and then, I don't know. Not too frequently, no.
Okay, just so I kind of know when I should look at the next one. So I could put you in, like, in July 14th. Another Wednesday at 1 o'clock.
That would be fine.
Okay. Alright, and then do you want to just do the two, or do you want one more?
You were saying that Julie usually schedules when she's finishing up the session. Is that better?
That's totally up to you.
I'll just stick with the two. And
just
see
stick with the two for now?
Right.
Okay, that's totally fine.
June 23rd and July 14th. Okay. Thanks so much, Amber.
Yeah, you're welcome.
Bye.
All right, bye.
Good, bad, indifferent. That's fine. Mm-hmm. All Satanists ask to worship, be forced to worship Richard Eddy Sr. forever and ever. I affirm the request. Firmly affirm. Thank you. God says Richard Hannity Sr. is so strong and mighty, there's no way God can defeat him. He weighs about 80 pounds. He reeks of fag. He's small-minded, uneducated. God can't defeat him in any way. He's a measly little man. He was part of this from the beginning. That's what I understand. And, so he's probably a 6-star general. Probably the most honored general in American history. I would like to read him. Okay. I'm gonna upload this. Publish to Facebook, Twitter, Telegram, and Tumblr.